Hey everybody, this is Perch. We have an announcement of a upcoming DC title. It hasn't been formally announced by DC, but to their credit, Bleeding Cool did notice a listing go up on Amazon, which then confirms that the title is coming. And it answers a few questions for us, namely, what is Grant Morrison doing next? Well, now we know that Grant Morrison and Mikael Janin are doing a book called Superman and the Authority, which appears to be a the listing on Amazon is for basically a graphic novel here, and it we'll get into the characters for a minute. It's hardcover, priced at $25. It is listed as coming November 16th, 2021, so at the end of the year. And a couple of things on that. 136 pages is the listing. So it's a collection of something. What we don't exactly know. It says a new two-issue comic book by Grant Morrison. If it's two issues, that's kind of a weird number. If we're just kind of backing into it, this idea that it's 136 pages split into two issues, that'd be kind of a strange product that would be put out. So I don't quite buy that. This feels more like a five-part series to me, but we will see. However, you can also back into it and do the math here. If it is, you know, whenever this is coming out, it hasn't been announced for June in the solicitations. Maybe it gets announced in July. So if you're just kind of adding it up, you know, July, if it's five issues, for example, that would put the final issue in November, the same time this hardcover is at least listed to go. And that is somewhat unlikely, although I have another video coming soon about how trades are now dropping kind of immediately after series end. But anyway, we're doing a lot of speculation here. Bleeding Cool seems to think it's two issues. I have my doubts based on the page count, but you know, who knows? They may be hearing something else. They're talking as though it's definitive, but there hasn't been true news. So you know, let's flip a coin. Maybe they're right. Anyway, this title, Superman and the Authority, looks to have a different view of Superman. It's an older Superman, for sure, in a costume that looks a little bit more in the future. And the team of the Authority, in this case, is made up of Midnighter, Apollo, Enchantress, Manchester Black, Omak, Natasha Irons, and maybe a Flash. And some kind of Flash, why not? And people like Manchester Black looks different in this variant. It seems like a big kind of combo of a few different things going on here with this title. So in terms of the creators on this book, you know, the Authority are, you know, was primarily, when people think of that, it was Warren Ellis, it was Mark Millar, who did kind of the big bulk of the runs here. There was, you know, Grant Morrison did touch on the Authority sort of, I mean, well, not sort of, but just for a second. So, you know, there DC has been flirting with the Authority coming into their comics for a while. We've seen certainly Midnighter show up and Apollo and other characters. It seems clear that this is kind of the continued meshing and merging. What's weird to me, I'll just say as an aside, is why, you know, there are fond memories of the Wildstorm titles and that whole kind of world. Things that certainly Jim Lee and Lobdell and others have, you know, people have played in that camp, Lobdell and Booth, with their kind of work on the Flash Forward material, showed some Wildstorm. They've been teasing this for a while. What's strange to me is DC is kind of injecting the Wildstorm characters, what feels like very ad hoc, into the universe, which kind of, it takes the nostalgia play that could come about from, you know, teams like the Authority and Stormwatch and others, and it kind of gives up on that value. And what I mean by that is, it, you know, there is a market out there. There's a fan base that remembers Wildstorm, remembers it fondly, and remembers those titles, and would kind of like to see things like Gen 13 or the Authority or Wildcats just show up and be kind of the core team they recognize. Instead, what DC's doing is kind of one by one, they're just sprinkling these characters all over the place. Grifter in Batman, and then we've got Midnighter showing up with Superman and everything else. And it's weird. It's weird to me that they don't take the obvious of just kind of keeping the team intact, keeping the recognizable group intact, and instead just kind of randomly throwing characters into DC. That doesn't help. That doesn't help. You're leaving money on the table from people who would normally buy these comics. So anyway, that's just saying. But here's a new comic. Now, what's interesting here is that, DC had announced a while back at the Comics Pro event a bunch of titles that would be coming out in 2021. And that included Deathstroke Inc., the Harley Quinn animated series sequel, a Wonder Woman anniversary title, Elseworld, DC Vampires, Robin and Batman, Joker, a Puzzle Box, The Legend of Batman, Crush and Lobo, Nubia and the Amazons, and DC Middle Ages. Of those, we really have only heard about Crush and Lobo. That, of course, is starting in June. But the rest of these are kind of just sprinkled in other places. But there are other titles. The Infinite Frontier book that did get announced that is going. We've seen a couple other things put out. They put a Mr. Miracle book out that was in there that is coming soon. And now The Authority. So there's a number of series that are coming out over the next several months. And it doesn't feel like they are, I don't know. It's from the outside. It's a weird approach at Comics Pro. They kind of announced these 11 new books, some of which are clearly, one shots, like the Wonder Woman 80th anniversary is a one shot, or maybe who knows exactly what that is. Joker, a Puzzle Box, I'm assuming that's an OGN of some kind or a one shot. It's a Crush and Lobo is a limited series. Deathstroke Inc., is that a limited series or ongoing? I mean, what do we have here? It's a very weird assortment of titles. And yet at the same time, you have some other things like this Superman, The Authority doesn't get announced. I still hear that there's a JSA book and an Aquaman book coming relatively soon. So where are those? It's just, it's the weirdest rollout. I'm sorry. It's just the strangest rollout I've seen. And the fact that, news articles are now being written based on, and again, to his credit, Rich trolling Amazon and finding listings rather than any kind of formal announcer from DC. That's strange, right? Especially with the creative team, Grant Morrison, Mikel Janin that's a very strong team right now. Grant Morrison obviously has a huge name. Mikel Janin is one of the artists that I think has drawn a lot of attention from DC in recent months. This is the two of them working together. That's a headline kind of announcement. I don't know. It's just weird to me. By the way, again, as another aside, I always have to laugh at whatever weird ass feud Rich Johnson of Bleeding Cool has with Mark Millar. Even in the article, he's going over the history of the Authority, and he's like, the series was then followed with a grosser, grubbier take by Mark Millar and Frank Quietly. A grosser, grubbier take, dude. How did Mark Millar hurt you in the past, Rich? Why do you do this? There's some kind of a background feud that just every time he goes into Millar, he's got to put these little digs in. So it's the weirdest thing. I just don't get it. But anyway, are you buying this? Superman and the Authority, the idea of Superman and with this team that, is it he leading this team? Is it a team that's out of control that he's trying to rein in? What is this story? Again, from the visual, certainly seems set in the future. It doesn't look near future, though, based on the ages of some of the other supporting characters that are there. It's nice to see Natasha Irons again. There's a character along with John Irons that I always feel like DC could do a lot with. And for whatever reason, they just keep, putting them aside and saying, oh, man, we need to create more, people of color characters. It's like, and you could use the ones you have, too. Just saying, they're right there. You can do more, but are you going to be buying this? Would you buy it? Are you interested in this concept? Is this what you were expecting Grant Morrison to do? Now, granted, I think this kind of concept does fit a lot of what Grant Morrison has been doing recently, and it kind of, it's his style. And so I think this is a good, this feels like a good title for Grant Morrison to do some stuff. Mikhail Janin is always welcome for me because I think his art's really clean. So are you going to be buying this? What do you think? What if it did come out as just two big issues? I meant to mention this earlier. This feels like a bit of an answer to last year's Three Jokers. I know for a fact that DC wants to have a Three Jokers style title every year. I think they had in their minds that Geoff Johns would be doing another one in 2021, but it now is feeling like maybe that's not happening or it's further out, the sequel. But I think that we're going to get this kind of prestige format type thing on an ongoing basis. But it's another comic book. Are you buying it? Let me know in the comments below. Like and subscribe, and thanks for listening.